Hello teacher and all my friends. Today our group will present a documentary about Chinese food culture.
Dumplings are symbolized as wealth, which can be made to look like ingots, which aren't bars, but both shape and oval.
Next, I like cake and Chinese people call nian gao.
When eating meal, the seating arrangement is probably the most important part of Chinese dining etiquette.
Seat of honor, or the highest status of the family,
is the one in the center facing in tent, and the guest of lowest position sit furthest from the seat of honor. When we talk about chopsticks in China, there were some rules not to do. Don't pass food from chopstick to chopstick. When a person dies and is cremated, their bones are passed from chopstick to chopstick. Don't insert it vertically into the bowls or dish. Chinese people do this only when their bones intend to sacrifice the dead. Therefore, having a meal with family is somehow a little happiness for some people.
Chinese people give a lot of attention to eating. Tea meal each day is not only to heal hunger, but also to reflect the understanding of the Chinese toward things. When a child is born, a close relative sends a yolk to the child's family. For context, yolk symbolizes the continuity of life and eating. Egg is a hope for descendants based on Chinese belief. Now, let us take a closer look at some of the Chinese eating culture.
First, don't eat until you see an adult using chopstick to put the first piece of food in his or her mouth. And when you are going to eat some food, you will need to choose a small piece. If you eat before an adult, it is considered a bad manner.
Now we are going to look at some similarities and differences between Chinese and Thai eating culture. Similarities: first, Thai and Chinese people eat after adults. Second, younger people always serve food to adults first. Third, while eating, don't eat rice and water at the same time. Differences: first, most Thai people don't use chopsticks to eat food. Second, Thai people use a spoon and a fork to eat food.
Moreover, while dining with an adult or other people greater of the same generation or older body, Thai and Chinese people eat calmly. They don't make noise and disturb others while eating. They don't speak when their mouth is full of food.
Now these are the similarities between Chinese and Thai eating manner. First, do not speak while there is food in the mouth. Second, do not chew food loudly. Third, do not knock the right dish while eating.
Next, while Chinese people are about to put food in their mouth, they choose the right piece of food, not too big. If they choose a piece that too big, it will be rude while they are chewing food.
Now, let's take a look at some more similarities and differences between Chinese and Thai eating culture. First similarity is don't scoop too much food into your own plate. Second, scoop the food carefully, don't mess up. Third, don't scoop food in front of others. And the difference is Thai people tend to eat food from all the dishes in order to show satisfaction and also to honor the host. How do you like the video presentation?
The content in the video is interesting. The details of the content are video about Chinese gastronomic culture. Because it's something that's close to us, it reflects the way of eating Thai and Chinese people. What problems did you have during the video production?
During filming, due to the circumstances of COVID-19, this prevents group members from working together to the fullest. This includes communication, hard and inconvenient page breaks. What is the strength or weakness of your video presentation?
The strength of video presentation is the topic that we choose about Chinese food culture, so it is easy to understand and approach it. Because in Thailand there are many Chinese people and Thai of Chinese descent, therefore this is familiar food culture for us. And the weakness is we cannot meet and work face to face, so that it is quite difficult to work together. What skills have you learned from making the video presentation? Again, more teamwork and planning skill by making this video, because we need to help each other plan for make this video. What English skill do you need to improve after this final project?
For English skill, I need to improve my English speaking skill to communicate and memorize more vocabulary used in everyday communication.
Thank you for watching video presentation for final project.